hate that you're gonna live that long.
Yeah,
I mean, there's so much.
Yeah, as you walk
tied with, to the faith.
Yeah, and faith is developed. You heard about developing faith, growing in faith. Faith is developed as you walk with God. See, as you walk with God, you start getting other expectations. Are your expectations get bigger? Are they grow? And you say, "Oh yeah, I got confidence in that." How do you have confidence in that? Well, because I have assurance that I can trust this God. Mm-hmm. And well, so there's a record of this God. Well, where's the record? And as we get in the lesson, we say, as we look back through the hourglass of time, you see that invisible God doing these things. And then you see also the promises of that invisible God. Now, there's a lot of gods that some people ascribe to, different people ascribe to, lots of gods. I used to subscribe to the Zodiac God on my car bumper. On my wall, ashtrays in the house, around my neck, showing faith in this Zodiac, and then I'll go and get a reading paper. This is what's happening for me today, here we go, That was so, and people still do that, rabbit foot in the pocket.
Yeah.
Won't leave? Yeah, crack a mirror. I'm just walking by that confidence. And that's not the way you deal with this invisible God. Here we go here again. So the evidence of things not seen, it means that it's in the invisible. It's invisible that will materialize. Not seen, but will materialize. Woo! So, faith is there's God existence, and then there is faith that you have to learn to walk in faith. And that's why it says, I think it's here in our lesson, the just shall walk by, I live by what?
Faith.
So, okay, I gotta live by this. I can't see, I can't walk by sight, the just cannot walk by what? Sight, but he has to walk by faith. Okay, so that's something totally, something that you, all right, now, let's go with our lesson again, that's what we have here. By the nature of faith, the components of faith, things, confidence in things that I expect, they're in the invisible. And by this method, by this nature, the elders obtained what kind of report? A good report. Elders. Who are elders? Everybody old?
No.
Everybody in church position in the church? That wouldn't be. That's not the elders he's talking about.
Could be grandparents.
That's right.
Could be grandparents. Could be anybody. Forefathers.
Who walked with God.
Yeah, right.
People of old who walked with God. Everybody, I can go to the drugstore and run into an elder. Be one of the biggest sinners out here. They're an elder. But that's not the elders that he's referring to. He's referring to elders who walked with God. They have a report. You ought to check out their report. Mm-hmm. They obtain a good report. And in other words, he's saying that it's demonstrated in the life of elders who walked with God. There's a demonstration of it, of elders who walked with God. So, as Brother Al was saying, it could have been one of your grandparents. My grandmother used to trip me out all the time. My dad was an alcoholic, stay out all night. Friday night, stay out in the Saturday morning, all night, worrying the family about when he's coming home. And when I go visit my grandmother, she said, "Yeah, I prayed all night the other night." I'm going, "How in the world did you pray all right. You know, how do you, I talk with God, oh, what? You know, I'm a little kid, I can't get, you mean what? You know, about your daddy, I prayed about him all night. And then, that he would be safe and come home off them streets, and da da da. And then come Monday morning, he'd go get up and go to work like that. That never happened. I said, well, Grandma's prayers are answered. You know, so they let me know that my elder, that elder, had a report with God. And I learned through looking back through the hourglass of time that some people have had a demonstration documented, if you want to say documented, that they walked with God in faith. Mm. So you see, God can exist without you walking in faith. You know, he need us to have faith. No, you need to have faith. He don't need to have faith for you. You need to have faith as we walk with him. So, okay, I don't know if it makes sense, but here we go. Okay, now. All right, walk with God. Now, through faith, we understand. How do you get an understanding? Study. Observe. Watch it. Check it out. I'm understanding. I haven't learned how to play golf yet, but I'm starting to get an understanding of it. You know, negative six. Yeah, he's a minus three. Is that good or bad? Minus 10. Wow, man. I should think, wow, he's sorry. No, that's good. That's good. So I'm starting to understand it now. So through understanding. And she says, as you look back through that hourglass of time, you get at what? We understand that the worlds, and worlds means the time periods, dispensations, if you want to get fancy, were framed by the what? Word of God. They were framed, already designed. He spoke it. He uttered it first. He framed it by his utterance. Ah, all the time periods, all the ages framed by what he uttered. Wow. And Genesis tells us that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And he, it says so much that he said, let there be. And he's... So he said, let there be, and there come the Eden time period, the Eden Garden time period. Now man is going into, from there on, other things spoken. Prophets speak about another time period. A prophet used by God. Time periods, he speaks it. It's going to be, there'll be a day when a virgin will conceive. Everybody thought he's crazy. You know, that was Isaiah. Prophets, holy men speaking as they were moved by what God told them to say and to say. So they said that. Okay. But we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are what? Seen were not made of things which what? Do appear. So yeah, when I was a couple of weeks ago and I was talking about bringing from the invisible to the visible, y'all looked at me like Brother Williams. So the things that were not seen. So faith is about things that are not manifested. I ain't got it now. I mean, it's not in my pockets. I don't drive around in it, or I don't have the practical everyday touch experience with it, but it's in the invisible, and my faith can bring it from invisible to my realm. Yeah. But it won't bring the unreal to my realm. It has to be real to get into my realm. You can't say I believe those things that are not as though they were. I believe a lie and turn it into a truth. No, you can't do that. doesn't work that way. But Joshua said the sun is real and it moves on that sundial. I can believe God to agree with me to stop that sun for me. And that's what he did, stop that sun. Whoa, man. So visible, invisible, and it's called revelation. Revelation. I can get a revelation from God as to what to have my prayers manifested. In other words, that if you understand God enough, you can get from that invisible revelation fellowship you have with God to make it exist in your realm. Visible. I can see it. That's heavy. It takes a Krispy Kreme and a cup of coffee to get deep. It's deep. You have to sit back and kind of smack and swallow. You get that.
It goes back to three, at the beginning of three, when you talk about understand, which could be translated as learn.
Learn.
So it's learn God.
It's learned. It's learned. And that's what you get. You get to, I've learned. I can trust him. I can expect from him. And I can experience it. And that's what Adam did before he sinned. They said God came down and talked with him to the cool of the day. What do you think it was talking about? The game? Adam said, help me understand this. And Adam's going by understanding our revelation. And he can name every animal and its purpose and its function from plant life to animal life to everything. How can you manage it if you don't understand what you got? So Adam was getting understanding from God. It's called revelation knowledge. It's getting understanding from the invisible God to bring it into, make it work in a visible realm. That's what Adam was doing. No need spending time with God if you ain't going to get that. See, some people go chant. They go to some place in Sedona, Arizona and chant. And you know, and burn their feet and all this and all that, and chant out in the woods and think they're going to get something. You can't get it that way. They don't, no. Yes, right. you got to get with
nobody
him according to his promises, according to what he has already done, looking back and say, you can bring that from, we can get that from invisible to visible. If it's already been done, it shouldn't really be a problem. Okay, all right. Now, all right. So, it says, without faith. See, a person can get born again, hallelujah, enough faith to be born again, get everlasting life, and not have a walk of faith. That's the most important thing I said this morning. A person can exist without a walk of faith. In the invisible existence. It's a lot of people in church without the walk of faith. And the walk of faith is only intensified, worthwhile, as you have trust in God. I trust in this God, now I'm going to walk with him through life. Come what may. I'm going to walk with him through life, and I'm expecting I have expectations of my hopes, dreams, inspirations to come to fulfillment as I walk with this God.
Well, I found that I fall off when I only have faith in myself.
In yourself, yeah, because there's a lot of options out here. You can opt out to go to my own strength, my job. my bank account. any other thing that's in existence, I can opt for that to be my strength. I will trust this invisible God that's done, brought all this into being that I see. I'm going to keep my trust in him. Okay. But some people can make this walk without it. And this is what he's saying here, that without faith, verse 6, without that walking and expectation, confidence, it is impossible to please him. Whoa. So I have to have this other component in my life, walking with God and confidently assured that he would bring my hopes, dreams, aspirations, and everything to pass in my life. And he says that without you having that type of assurance, type of confidence about him, you can't please him.
people, they buy the essence of the resurrection story,
mm-hmm.
but they don't get an understanding of what it really is. And mm-hmm. as soon as you understand exactly what Christ did for you, there's no problem having the confidence.
Yeah, mm-hmm. now you got to go out and walk in that confidence. Wow. Now you got to walk in that confidence. Like I said, this came to me because the disciples, before they knew that he had risen from the dead, they were in hiding. You know, hiding out in the woods, hiding. Peter, I'm going fishing. I'm out of here. Peter said, I don't know him. You know, what was he? I don't know. They don't have no kind. They're scared. But as soon as Peter was convinced that Christ was risen from the dead, he had all kind of crazy boldness. Oh, no, Lord, I ain't scared. They said they're going to kill me and hang me tomorrow if I go out and preach. Guess what? I'm going out preaching. You know, I'm in your name. I'm going out preaching. So they had all kind of confidence. And this is what he said. So from now on, walk in confidence. Expect him to do. And he says, if you can't walk with me like that, then we're not walking together. Because that's how he exists.
You know, Pastor Lynn, sometimes you hear people say that and they don't really even understand. Mm-hmm. Have you ever heard people say, if everything falls into place,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
this will happen?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah,
really saying that if God makes everything around you happen like it's supposed to, then things will work out.
Yeah, it's like if you say, I'm going to interview for this job, I've been wanting it, God, you know, I'm believing you, the man's going to give me the job, I'm going to eventually get the job. So from the time I got up off my knees out of prayer with you to the time I sat down for that interview, my expectations is that every day I get the job. Boom. I don't have any thoughts about, well, somebody else good looking, smarter than me, going to sit down with this guy.
Of course, God has to have talked to the employer.
God, somehow through the period of time, you have always worked stuff out so that when I get there in the visible, bam, job mine. that's what you believe. That's what you expect. And God wants you to have those kind of expectations of him. Woo. Don't worry about nothing else, but your expectations is that this is the confidence. This is the assurance. This is what I'm hoping. My expectations is this. And as you walk with God, talking with God, you sit down and you tell the man, this is my salary. These are the days I want off. This is how I roll. This is how I roll. I like these kind of hours. I'm good like this in these kind of hours. And this is how I roll. And the guy sees what? Your confidence, your assurance. And you go in with the strength of God with you. And boom, up and up. That's how God rolls. You don't roll in doubt. not sure. He don't roll in that.
It would really trip you out if he said, okay, God already told me that.
Yeah, I have a feeling. I've been looking for somebody like you. We need somebody like you.
I was expecting you to do it.
Yeah, we need somebody like you around here. Okay, praise God. So, but without faith, it is impossible. It is and to please him. All right, now, so we have talked about the nature of faith. We're going to jump into the things that we face down here on the ground. Walking here on the earth. Because some people think they're in faith and they don't have to face up to the real smacks up here on earth.
Crack.
Life smacks. Crack. And then they say, I'm going to turn the unreal to the real and walk around in ignorance and stupidity instead of approaching and walking and trusting God in faith. And then come and get victory down here on the ground. Woo! Let's get a Krispy Kreme for us. All right. We're going to talk about utterance. Genesis 1 and 3 through verse 26. You take that, write that down, take it home. Genesis 1st chapter, verse 3. I mean, chapter 3. Genesis, the first chapter, verse 3 through 26. Okay. So we're going to talk about dilemmas. Let's see. That's just a long. That's a lot of reading in that one. But 1 Peter 1:7. Let's see what he says there.
Is it first Peter 1?
Yeah, first Peter 1 and 7. Ooh. Ooh. That's how people change church membership. denomination and everything else. When a trial comes. What does it say there? That the trial of what?
The trial of your faith.
The trial of your walk with God. There it is. The trial of your faith. Much more precious. In other words, it says your faith is much more precious than what?
Gold.
That perish. Though it be tried extremely hard with fire. Might be found unto the praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. Man, we should have donut coffee on that. But the testing, here comes something to call your faith a lie. Here comes something to say it ain't going to work for you. Here it comes. You're down on the ground. They call it ground zero these days. You're down on the ground, and you got this. Here it comes. Real life is true. Bam. The trying of your faith. Your confidence. Full expectation. I know it's going to come out this way good for me. Well, here comes a test for you. You going to stay in faith or not? The trial of your faith. Even the trial. Let the trial, okay, you got the trial, you didn't bargain for it, but there it is. Stand up to it. Stand up to it, look it straight in the eye. That's a battle that's precious. That's a battle that's precious. It's in the what? Moment. It's the now. It's the moment. It's the now. Abraham, take that kid up there on the hill and cut his throat. It's in the now. Wait a minute. God is the only kid that got it. It took me 100 years to get it. Abraham took the kid up there on the mountain and cut his throat. In the now. Come on, boy. Come on, boy. And then he told the servant, wait right here.
We'll be back.
And that means that I don't know how God's going to work it out, but he's going to work it out. But yeah, I heard him, and this is what he said. This is what his word says. Here we go. So the trying of your faith, you get sick, and you turn from the word. Oh, boy, I got something else. Peter was like that when he didn't believe in the resurrection of Jesus. I'm going fishing. Where are you going, Peter? Going fishing. I can't do this. I'm through with this. He ain't alive. I'm going fishing. Doing something else. Trial of your faith. You're going to do something else, or you're going to stay right where you are. With God. So when Peter found out that he was alive, Peter says, I'm going all the way with him. So you know that you have confidence in the invisible God who created all of this. As you look back through that hourglass of time, I'm standing right here. I'm standing right here. The trial is right here. I'm standing right here. It ain't bigger than the God that made the sun, the moon, the stars, the sea, and all that's in it. It ain't bigger than that. And in Psalms, we're going to get to Psalms in a minute. Psalms says, though I'm dying believing. I'm dying trusting. If I die, you'll say he was dying trusting. Like the man trying to climb the mountain. If I don't come back, it's because you saw me dead on the side of that mountain. But I'm climbing out. I'm getting to the top of that mountain. And the only reason why, because you saw me on the side of it. I died on my way up. That's trust. Praise God. So the trial of your faith being much more precious than of gold that perish, though it be tried with what? Fire, might be found to praise and glory and honor and glory. So, yeah. Let's see if that's the trying, testing that quality of your faith. Woo, man. All right. So, All right. Now, how can we stand like this? How can we stand? You have to have some sure facts. Sure facts. Here we go. Psalms 46 and 1. Sure fact. A sure fact. It has to be established. What does it say there, Candy?
God is our refuge and strength. Mm. A very present help in trouble.
Say, in trouble. In trouble. In trouble. In, he ain't running. He ain't backing down. On the schoolyard, I had an older sister, a twin brother, so I had at least, it was three against one if something come up. I was going to be the three of us if something come up. And I said, no need to run. Running, present, right now, in the now, a very present help when the trouble comes, in the time of trouble. And, you know, I wish I could sell you no trouble coming. Anybody buy that?
Nope.
Send me $5. No trouble coming. I sell you that all day long, and it's a good thing to hear, and people will want to buy into it. No trouble. I'll buy that plan. Yeah, I'll buy that, man. But only down here on the earth, if trouble comes, boom. He's a present help when trouble shows up. Contrary to God, something happened. Contrary to God's word, everything's all messed up, negative, Satan, everything. But where is God? Boom, present. 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 So he's present. And what is he when he's present? A very present. He's a refuge. Hide in his word. And he's your strength. Because he knew that you're going to what? You're going to buckle. You're going to buckle. So let it lean on him,
yep.
And he's your very present help in when trouble shows up. Ooh. So, and this is what David says, because of knowing that, I will not what?
Fear.
I will not fear. Though the earth, and this is how he qualifies it, though the earth be what? Removed. Somebody finish that out for me. Though the earth be removed.
And though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea.
Though the earth be moved and the mountains fall into the sea. I ain't going nowhere. I am not changing my position. That's when you're walking with God. How about Enoch when he walked with God? You think it's because of an earthquake? Well, God, I see you. I got to go see why I'm getting out of here. You shaking this thing up going on? What's wrong with you? I'm out of here. Enoch kept walking with God. Mm-hmm. Fellowship with God. Loving God. Mm-hmm. Kept all that. Trouble all over the earth. Stuff going on all over the place. The earth be removed. The mountains fall into the sea. Mm-hmm. Man. The waters thereof roar and be what? Trouble. How many have had this much trouble in your life? You thought you ain't seen the earth move. We move off this axle. Axis. Instead of this is the floor, that's the floor. That'll shake you up on it. Mm-hmm. The mountains. Mm-hmm. See them falling too. Be carried away to the midst of the sea. The waters, trouble, tsunamis, I guess. Mm-hmm. Though the mountains shake and the swelling thereof, he says, peace. Peace anyway. Negative report, bad report, something bad, the trouble. Like, man, how could it happen? What am I gonna do? He says, I know you're buckling, but I'm your strength. Because you're seeing it with your visible eye. Yeah. You're feeling it with your body and everything. You're buckling up and he says, I'm here, right here presently. I'm holding you up. I've got your back. So then you have to determine, okay, I'm going to stay with you guys, but I'm the weak one in this deal. I want you to know that. You already know that I'm holding you up. because I got to be your strength because it hit you in the face, blindsided you. And then you got, then pretty soon you got to bounce back. I mean, brothers play football and you had to bounce.
Yeah.
You know, oh boy, he got me. Whoever that was, he got me. I'm trying to, you know, how many ever walked to the wrong huddle?
This smells so loud.
See, walk to the wrong huddle. They come out, you say, with that smelling salt, snap you back out. You still trying to figure out. You know, you got slapped around pretty good. Hold up, we're here to help you. We're trying to bring you back. So now how can I trust him? He said, okay, let me see what he has done. Give me a report. Give me a live report. I mean, give me something. Tell me something that he done done. Give me a record of him. All right, that's what's that? Psalms 46:8. Is that right? Yes.
See the works of the Lord.
Oh, the Lord. Psalms 46:8. Ooh, gotta get there.
Listen.
Is it okay? Glory. So go ahead and read that then.
Come, yeah. Behold the works of the Lord, mm-hmm. What desolations we have made in the earth.
Yeah, come and see. Behold, he said, look. Come and look. That's what behold means. Come. Come and look. Now, how far are you going to have to look? You've got to look all the way back. Look through that hourglass of the ages, of the time periods, and see if God has ever been working in those time periods. Mm-hmm. Or look through the hourglass of your life. Has God ever been in there, with or without me, helping him out? Yeah. He showed up at some time in your life when you couldn't do nothing about it, and he did something that made a difference. Helped you out. Who was nothing, just keeping you alive for another day. It was something. He showed up somewhere. So let's see his work. Let me look back and see his work. Because right now, if I look over here, oh boy, stuff's falling apart. Let me see, has he ever done anything in the earth? Because that's what you got to find. As soon as you can, find something that God has done. Because it's going to come. I'm not going to prophesy it's going to come, but trouble comes, smack you upside the head, knock you cuckoo. You got to figure out, find something. What has God done? In my life or anywhere down here. But I knew it was God, wasn't me.
And get stuck on John 3:16.
Yeah. So come look at his works. Come look what he has done. Desolations he had made in the earth. In the earth. This means right where you are, he's been there before. He's been right where you stand in before. He's been there on that earth before. He made wars to what? Cease to the ends of the earth. He breaketh the bow. Cut it the spear and asunder, he burneth the chariot and the fire. And that was, he did all of that for the benefit of his people when they were in trouble. So when we were in trouble before, that's what he did. So I can see my grandmother praying and saying, you know, man, it was like this back in the day. It was like that. Child, I would pray all night. He's always tripped me out. How do you pray? Oh, how do you do that? He stayed up all night. Y'all was praying for y'all over there. And I said, as bad as that drunk was acting, it could have been worse if she wasn't praying. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm glad she was praying. I would hear him rumbling and bumbling and cussing and breaking stuff all in the house. I don't know why I'm using my own dad. And I thought it was terrible then. But she said, she was praying all night. So that situation could have been worse without her praying. Somebody in faith praying. Said, walking with God in faith. So here he says, God, for the benefit of his people, he stopped the war. He destroyed a war that was up against his people. That's what he'll do. So it could be like circumstances, life has called a war on you, call all the troops, nuclear war on you, on your household. But he says, if he can stop a war, break a weapon, and do all these kind of things for his people, he'll do it again for you and for us. All right, thank you. He breaks the bow, cut the spear, burn the chariot for his people. So this is what he says when the yogurt hits, I like to say the yogurt hits the fan. What's the first thing for you to do?
Be still.
Be still. Be still. Be still. First thing we want to do is do some things so contrary and walk right out of faith because we get in motion. Just be still. Yeah, be still. See, my brother and older sister, and so on, I was a peaceful guy. Believe it or not, I was a peaceful guy. And someone give me trouble, they push me back out of the way. I was like, stand there. I was like, just stand there. Hey, no, I just had to stand there and watch it go down. I just stood there, you know, they pushed me. I said, hey, that's all right. It'd be all right. It's cool, you know. Said, come on, walk on this way. And then we learned how to do that for them. There's 11 of us. We learned how to do that for the rest of them. They knew when stuff happens out there, they just stood back. And then everybody else comes and fight. You fight one, you got to fight about eight of them. So we better leave it alone. So he goes to battle for you, and he tells you to get back out the way. Oh, stop right here. Just stay right there. Know that I'm God. I will be exalted among the what? The heathen. That trouble to come to you, he says, it's going to have to bow down to me. It's got to deal with me. God. I would be exalted in the earth. So he says they're not going to rise up above me. I'm stepping in. That's what he said. I'm stepping in. Good enough. So he says God is with you, right? Verse 11. The Lord of hosts is what? With us. God of Jacob. Our hiding place. Our hiding place. So if trouble come. Life can call nuclear war, you, your household, everybody else, stand still. Stand still. I got to go run down over here, over there, and tell this and do that, and move this and hide that and do that. He said, no, just stand still. And no, you've been walking with me. I'm not going to let anything on the earth override me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So that's walking in, that's what. Yeah, faith, when it's faith, yeah, it's now, but it's always in the moment. Mm-hmm. In the moment. In the moment. Glory to God. That's what we got.